Welcome to this UniLogic tutorial. UniLogic is the complete application development environment for our Unitronics UniStream control platform.
Hello, my name is John Anastasides and I'm an applications engineer here at Unitronics. A popular protocol supported by the UniStream is File Transfer Protocol, better known as FTP. FTP is a client-server protocol involving the transferring of various files. These files can range from data tables, sampler files, PDFs, and CSV files. The client will send data to and retrieve data from the server. The server may be a remote PC or another PLC in some cases. When using the UniStream for FTP, files will be stored on the controller's SD card. Now that we have some background on FTP, let's take a look in UniLogic. For this tutorial, a 7-inch UniStream will be configured as an FTP server. A PC FTP client program will then be used to demonstrate how FTP works on the UniStream when configured as a server. In order to configure the server, navigate to PLC Communications in the Solution Explorer. Select Physical and Panel Ethernet. The panel IP address is set to 10.2.2.90. This IP address will act as the host address for connecting with the PC's FTP client. Next, navigate to Protocols. Select FTP, then FTP Servers, and add a new FTP server. These are the subject fields that must be entered. Give the server a name, then create a case-sensitive username and password, the FTP client will use this information to access the server. The server can be defined as read-only by selecting the read-only checkbox. That is all that is required in order to define an FTP server configuration within UniLogic. Once the FTP server is configured, the project can be downloaded. The download was successful. A VNC viewer is open and displaying the UniStream's HMI on the left side of the screen. Currently, it is showing the contents of the controller's SD card within UniApps. I have created a folder on the controller's SD card specifically for FTP communications called FTP, which is located in the User Logs folder. In this folder, I have created a file called receive.csv that I will use for this example. This is the file that I will receive from the UniStream's SD card with the PC's FTP client. On the right of the screen is the PC FTP client program that will be used to demonstrate sending and receiving files. I have also created a file on my desktop to send to the UniStream server called send.csv. It is important to note that all FTP client software may look different, however the information required to connect will be the same for any client. First, enter the UniStream IP address in the host bar. Next, enter the username and password that were created within UniLogic. Lastly, enter port 21, as this is the default FTP port. Select Quick Connect and connect to the server. The UniStream's SD card directory can be seen on the right side of the client browser. The PC directory can be seen on the left side of the browser. First, I will demonstrate sending a file to the server with the PC FTP client. Select the path of the file on the UniStream's SD card. Currently, there is only one file located on the UniStream SD card, receive.csv. The transfer was successful. Update the folder in UniApps to see that send.csv is now located on the UniStream's SD card. Next, I will demonstrate the receive command. Verify the password of the server and select OK. The transfer was successful. Receive.csv is now located on the PC desktop. This concludes the FTP server tutorial. There are many uses for FTP on the UniStream, whether it be receiving important information from a hard-to-reach server or simply freeing SD card space on a client controller. If you're interested in FTP clients, please view the FTP client video. I hope this information helps with your future programming, and thank you for watching.